Hello, I'm Chris Kelly, Applications Engineer with Keysight Technologies, and today we're in a series of videos discussing how to measure the highly variable current consumption by battery-operated IoT devices. Today, we're going to discuss the N2820 series oscilloscope probes that you can add to an existing oscilloscope to measure current. Remember, the native measurement on an oscilloscope is usually voltage. These N2820 current probes allow you to get in and measure the current at bandwidths up to 3 megahertz. Now, probing is very important. If you don't have short, high current leads going to your device under test, you're going to have a difficulty measuring precisely. So looking at the oscilloscope now, we have a wearable fitness band, which is in a fairly idle mode. And on the oscilloscope, we see a lot of measurements going by very rapidly. They're very low duty cycle, very high amplitude pulses. Let's capture a few of these pulses and take a look. In this example, you can see along the bottom here very low current pulses happening, and then very intermittently we have very tall activity. Using the oscilloscope, I can go in and characterize that very accurately and see exactly what's being measured on this device. You can then go in and say, how often are these things measured? The duty cycle on these devices may be 500 or 1,000 to 1, and the longer you spend off, of course, the longer life you're going to get from your battery. So with 3 or 4 or 5 different levels of current spread out over a great deal of time, the oscilloscope is a very fast, easy tool to use if you add these current probe oscilloscope probes to your toolkit. So we've overviewed how current source probes, current probes can measure waveforms up to fairly high bandwidths on these low current, low power consumption devices. Using these measurements, you can extend the battery life of your device. Thank you for watching.